Now there's audio.
Oops.
So now we're going to the final song. And come over the way from there and we'll take it back. Joseph went to Kenmore Elementary and taught at middle school before making the decision to attend Urban Adventist Academy for his high school career. During the high school, Joseph was very involved in and associated with student body. SB Student Ministries concert band and played on the school's first soccer team. Joseph graduated from Auburn Adventist Academy in 2020, and in the fall of 2020, he started his college career at La Sierra University, studying medicine with major in business management of healthcare. Joseph had dreams of becoming an orthopedic trauma surgeon. Joseph was known and loved by many, and those that knew him know that he was a people person and loved to entertain. Even when Joseph was little, he would love to put on performance in front of his family with his cardboard cutout guitar. He always succeeded in making everyone smile and laugh and just feel. Strangers were had. His grandfather, Joseph, and grandmother, Anne Egweso of Kisii, Kenya, as well as three of his uncles from Nairobi, Kenya. He is survived by his parents, Shadrach, Tracy, brother Jacob, grandparents George and Sharon Spritchell of Wenchin, Washington, Uncle Sammy Nyangweso of Portland, Washington, and Kevin Critchell of Wenchin, Washington, as well as many uncles and aunts in Kenya. The cousins Maylin, Bennett, Andrew, Jaylin, all of Washington State, as well as many cousins in Kenya. Joseph lived an extraordinary life filled with adventure, optimism, passion, positive energy, laughter, and love. We will be. He will truly be missed by everyone who knew him. Thank you.
Each one of us has got a story about Joseph. I could start, but I'm going to do further. You could turn me and Joseph to small kids in the gymnasium to teach us how best to work out. We are now going to hear some of the stories about Joseph. We're going to let tears flow. And we're also going to have laughter to hear. And we're going to start turning those stories into memories about Joseph. And to acknowledge that we are all different because Joseph was here. Leading us in our stories today is Kobe. Joseph is roommate in college. Kevin, I hope I'm pronouncing your name well, and Uncle Rowan, who's a white man, Madison, Faith Njenga, Metcalf, Nicole, Magaki, and Andrew Nyangweso, you all line up here. I give you strictly 2 minutes. So we start with Kobe.
I really like to do this. I met Joseph. We didn't go to school together. We didn't work together. But one day we found each other. We both went snowboarding at Big Bear. And well, both of our friends had totally ditched us because we had no idea what we were doing. But he saw me in the singles line, and he was too. And he gave me that huge grin. And he's like, hey, you want to run together? Do it, you know? And as we're going up the mountain, it's like, so, what do you want to be when you grow up? This is the first question he asked me. I was like, I want to be a doctor. He's like, no way, I'm going to be a doctor too. You know? With him, it was never, I want something, or I think something. It's, I'm going to do that. I will do this. Thank you. set his mind to it, that it was going to happen. From that moment on, we became lifelong friends. In that single year, I think we went about 30 times. 2-3 times a week. It was an amazing connection from then on. Toughest years of my life, but for some reason, anytime I was in those really dark moments, Joseph had a phone right to my heart, and he would call me, and I'd be like, how does this guy do this? Every time, you know, I set my work aside, I'm done for the day, I haven't talked to anyone for 8 hours, 10 hours, and then I get Joseph. Hey man, I gotta tell you something. This is crazy. And he would tell me the craziest things. He made my day so many times, over thousands of miles away, and I know for everybody else, he gave you guys support in some of your toughest moments, when you didn't even know you needed it, but for some reason, he always knew. You guys raised an amazing, loving, kind-hearted, and passionate child, and I thank you so much for allowing him to come into my life, and everybody else here that was his friend. They are so thankful for Joseph. He brought us together like no other. And for what you guys have lost, you guys have gained 10 more sons, 10 more daughters. We're so happy to be your guys' family. And thank you for having us. And Joseph, we love you, buddy. We'll see you soon.
Here we are. I'm Uncle Kevin, what I have to say is not necessarily a specific story or anything, but more just how I saw him as a for me. So here we go.
Compassionate, sincere, forgiving. Just a few words Amos would use to describe him. As a young boy, I remember Joseph always wanted to be right next to
him. Sitting at a table for a meal, he wanted to sit so close that he might as well have been in your lap. Sometimes to the annoyance of the ones nearby. Over the years, I have seen that affection grow into love for people. Joe didn't want anyone left out and wanted everybody to feel loved. Many of his classmates and teachers have given testimony to his kindness and love, stating that he went out of his way to welcome anyone new and becoming their first friend in their new life adventure.
But when I first heard the news about Joseph, I was in Kenya, and I was in denial about it for the entirety of the trip because I so badly wanted to believe that it was a lie. Our families have been friends for over 8 years now, and I've had a hard time coming to terms with this loss. When I first heard the news about Joseph, I was in Kenya and was in denial about it for the entire of the trip because I so badly wanted to believe that it was not, that it was a lie. Our families have been close friends for over years now. So I had a very hard time coming to terms with the news, coming in terms with the reality of him not being here anymore. I dreaded coming back home because I knew that this day was coming. I kept asking God why he took him away from us as soon, because he had so much potential and was so close to accomplishing his lifelong dream of becoming a doctor.
He never took life for granted. He was always enjoying it. This week I spent a whole day at his house until the middle of the night with our families, sharing funny memories about him and mourning him. Joseph made us all so happy, and I kept wishing that he was also his legacy that will always remain with us. Joseph, there's not a single day where I don't think about you and miss you. I'm so proud of the smart and beautiful man that you are becoming. You and your family will always be a part of my family, and I'm so honored and blessed to have known you. I pray and hope that one day I'll get to see you and fetch a smile again and have one more adventure with you. May you rest in eternal peace, Joseph, and I love you so much.
Allison, I have been friends with Joseph since the very beginning of our freshman year of college together, and so I just have a few words for Joseph, just to kind of share the kind of person that I've been. So, it feels so hard to try and encapsulate the person that you were in a few minutes. Driven, charismatic, confident, friendly, genuine, with a love for life and for people. From the day that I met you, you lived your life with a passion and intensity that you applied to every facet of your life. You were not in any way a small presence, and you were anything but quiet, and your confidence was so strong that it was emulated by everyone around you. You possessed a brightness that touched countless lives, and a gravity that constantly drew people to you. Going anywhere with Joseph felt like traveling with a celebrity. No matter where we went, there was someone you knew. There's, hey, you expanded my world and the world of so many people around you and all the people here today. I have so many memories with you, from building your bed at 2 a.m. after moving you to L.A., late night dinners at our favorite restaurants, working out together, gossiping with each other over your gourmet meals. And we're talking about Joseph wanting to be a doctor. And he told me, I don't care if anyone thinks that I'm overconfident or too ambitious, because that's what makes doctors great. And you know, Joseph, that's what makes you great. A big head, but an even bigger heart to match it. We laughed together every day, and we fought with each other every other day. But no matter what, you were always there to support me and me for you through any of the tough times. There are so many here who will claim you as a brother, and I feel really lucky to be part of that group of people. You are a constant ray of sunshine in the dark, and I will continue to keep your memory alive by striving to emulate that light. I love you, and I miss you. I hope to see you again soon.
Meeting Joseph at the gym. And our first encounter was a debate over his blonde tips that I did not agree with. And talked about taking care of your curls, valuing them, and it turned into a friendship after he had decided to apply to our gym. And the guy actually got the job, and I was shocked. But when I met him, he quickly taught me the importance of hope. And I remember a point in my life where I was at a point of hopelessness, and he really helped me manifest my confidence again, and brought me back to a space where I was able to be proud of myself. And that wasn't possible without Joseph. I can tell you plenty of stories. Some maybe not fit for here, but that was Joe, right? That was Joe. He had such a dynamic character, a dynamic man at that. But one thing that never wavered was his confidence. We used to say irrational confidence. It works every time. And I would say to everybody out here today, especially the young ones, to take this and run with it. You know, life isn't happening to us, it's happening for us. And to remember that Joseph would want us all to chase our dreams, find what makes you happy, and be that. Be the person that you want to be, because that's exactly who he was. Joseph chased his dreams every day, unrelenting. He did it in a manner that some of us couldn't always get behind, but as Maddie said, he didn't care about how he came off. He cared about making the people around him, making his friends and family proud. And as we can all see today, he definitely did that. With that being said, Joe, guy, don't worry about it, dog. We'll take care of it on this end. To the families, and we apologize that we won't be eating your food, and we will be indulging in great memories moving forward. Jacob, you got a couple more big bros, dog. Don't worry about it. We got your back. Not alone. So with that being said, I appreciate everybody for allowing me to speak. And see you later, Joe.
I have known Joseph since he was a kid. Chats, neighbor, and friend. The most interaction with Joseph was during high school. He was polite, intellectual, smart, and very charming young man. I often teased Chad about the only reason I love him because of his voice. Chad always smiled, but I'm sure he loved that because it was a testimony how a great job he did, him and Tracy, raising up the two boys. I will never forget our talks. I mean, someone will wonder what a man in my age will talk and discuss with Joseph. Well, it was all about school, about the importance of education, about being successful in life. And to my surprise, he was very interested in that topic, and he always came back to talk to me about it. He was passionate about school and being successful. I will never forget the excitement every time he saw me to come and talk to him. Because I knew I was going to miss the big smile and the friendly heart he always gave me. It was an honor knowing Joseph, knowing a very impressive young man. I will always cherish his memory. I always thought that he would be someone important. I mean, he had the confidence that everybody shared and talked about. He was always passionate about being somebody important. And unfortunately, his life was cut short. He was taken too soon and too young from his family, from his relatives, from his friends. Joseph, may God have mercy on your soul, and may heaven be your eternal.
Joseph and I grew up together, from seeing who could burp the loudest to arguing over who was smarter based on report cards. We were always competing. I guess I'll give it to him now. You were definitely smarter, but I've always been taller. My earliest memories, he was there, from scaring my spot. It's almost scary how fast time can fly. One day we were playing tag, and the next we were celebrating our high school graduation. We probably shouldn't have been doing. I'm sorry, I'm shouting on you, Tracy. It's almost scary how fast time can fly. One day we're making TikToks in my mom's kitchen, packing our bags for college to fly to opposite sides of the country. And the next, my heart dropped to the ground, denial swarming my mind. It hurts when the universe calls us to remind us how sacred. I wear white to honor the amazing son, brother, grandson, cousin, nephew, and friend he was to many, to shine light on his precious spirit as we guide his soul home. While this goodbye came much earlier than we could have ever imagined, I hope we can all celebrate the beautiful life he lived. To one of my oldest friends, thank you for the laughs. Thank you for the hugs. Thank you for the debates and for taking the wrong.
taught them until they are gone. He has taught me to be ambitious. He has taught me to be hardworking, and ultimately, to live my life to the fullest. You would see he would be found doing what he wanted to do and do it with ambition to the 100% of his able. You would see he would take action. You would see he would be very passionate. And although we may not be able to see what he's able to do, we may not be able to see now, but we know his. Quick story about Joseph and just my experience. As soon as I walked through the door, Jacob and Joseph were just at the door, just telling me, oh, this, just bringing so much things to my plate. And that's what Joseph was. He had so many things that he used, as you could say, an army Swiss knife. He had so many things that he was good at, so many things that he wanted to be good at. He just wanted to do everything. I remember Jacob and Joseph, we would compete all the time with everything that we did. We would be in the living room wrestling. He was a competitive person, very ambitious person. Last thing I want to say is we have one life, and we strive to live it to the best of our ability. And I think Joseph
at this point, I want to invite representatives of the Harvard Academy to come and give their tributes. So I'm going to ask, first of all, Beatrice Roberts, followed by Trenton Russell, and then the principal will follow. Because before Joe came to Harvard Academy, he went through my class, my Sabbath school class. And I've always used that approach of getting to know the kids first before you can reach the parents. Good job, Harvard Academy, that you did in the life of Joseph and in the life of many of our children that we sent here from our various schools. The school program today so that members of this community could be here. So at this moment, I want to invite Beatrice Roberts to come forward if she's here, followed by the principal, followed by Trenton Russell and then the principal. If Beatrice is not here, then Trenton, I am.
For being here. I'm an aunt to Joseph from New Jersey. We are truly sad. We are truly hurt. But as the Bible says, we mourn as people that have hope. And that's our message to Shad, Tracy, Jacob, and the rest of the family, and all the communities here. As painful as this is, and even as he has departed, his amazingness will continue to follow him. His impact will be seen for years to come. And for that, we are thankful. Shad and Tracy, and all of our families and friends, we take heart. And we continue to thank God for Joe's life.
My name is Trent Russell. I had the privilege of teaching Joe across the street. Joseph was not a mischievous kid, but he loved to have a good time. I was talking last night with one of his classmates, Josie, and she told me a story about a time where they were working together at the academy, and they decided they wanted to come across the street and have a cold drink from the ABC. But they didn't want to get in trouble, so naturally they climbed out the window. They went back through the front door as if nothing happened. But the best part of the story is that Josie still has a video on her phone of Joseph climbing out the window and his pants getting caught on the window and ripping up the side. And Joseph loved to have a good time. I had the privilege of teaching him in my band. He played bass clarinet. Joseph always thought he was a little better than he was. That's not to say he didn't learn and grow. He absolutely did. But he learned to rely. We had an opportunity to take a band trip to New York, and Joseph came with us. He wasn't in my group this day, but he was in my wife's group with my son. And as they were touring New York City, Katie was taking pictures. And after we heard the news, she was looking through those pictures, and she found one in particular of my son, then 8 years old, on Joseph's shoulders. When he saw this picture a couple weeks ago, he said, "Mom, that class practically raised me." See, Joseph meant a lot to us. All of our students are important to us. And while Joseph loved to have a good time, he loved to care about you. So today, as we're filled with grief and sorrow, you can look back on those funny stories and the ripped pants. And we can look forward together to the best day ever.
My name is Peter Backenbaum. I joined Auburn Adventist Academy Joseph's sophomore year. As sophomore years, fun year with 10th graders, and I'm looking across at some of the classmates that I'd end up seeing running around the corner of the hallway or being involved with some activity, and if I had to talk to them, I'd get one thing that has been consistent through this is a smile from Joseph. I'd have some flat faces, like we've been good. Talking to him about his homework. He was still searching for his role and his place in school, in his classwork. And he would always talk about getting it done, and he'd work toward it. And then we were all there and blessed when he discovered his passion. Remember that transition? And it was significant. And that's what growing up is about. And he discovered his passion to become a doctor. And he turned a corner. And when he turned that corner, excellence came into existence. And he moved forward with a passion that was, you could touch it, you could feel it. And he embraced that his senior year, preparing him to go on to university. The consistency that we have heard. We heard on a daily basis, Tracy. Joseph, in every class, as we begin with worship and prayer, he would pray for his family, and he would pray for you and your health. And he was praying for his mother and his family and his loved ones every day, multiple times a day. We have seen and experienced how each of us have been blessed by how much he cared. So that not only inspired us when he was here with us, but it will inspire us until our Lord comes and takes us home.
Thank you so much for sharing those stories about Joseph. I can see it imagining in my mind. In the words of Alan Alexander, if there ever comes a day when we can't be together, keep me in your heart. I will stay there forever. At this moment, I'm going to outside of the United States in Nairobi, Kenya. So I'm going to invite Joseph to serve as Uncle Henry Nyangwesa. And he will also introduce the rest of the family members who are coming from Nairobi.
Mona's, my dear friends, brothers and sisters, church members and colleagues, good afternoon. It's that sorrowful moment that we find ourselves here to bid farewell to our dear son. Family of Shadrach, as we call him Kariuki Nyangweso, is a big family. A few of our brothers are here and sisters who came to witness this ceremony. I want to take this chance before I say something. Just to introduce the family members who are here. And I want you to understand that in Africa, we are all related. I want to take this chance who are within the congregation just to stand. Wherever you came from, our friends from Africa who are in the congregation. Many of them have come from various stations in this country. May I therefore request my brothers and sisters who are here, just to come up front together with their children so that I can be able to introduce them. the family of Shadrach, we were 9 brothers and 3 sisters. Unfortunately, 3 of our brothers have already slept. The elder brother is represented by others who are online, Julie Mdoni and the children. They are not here, but they are watching us online. Then the second, followed by Abel Nyangweso, who passed away last year. The third one is our sister Margaret Obebo, together with their family and children. They are also watching us online. I am the fourth one. Then the fifth is Elijah Nyangweso. He managed to come with a dear wife, Violet, and their children are also back in Kenya. They are watching us online. Then the sixth born is represented by Lee. Lee, where are you? Come. Lee Onsare. Lee Onsare's father passed away in 2003, but his son is here and he lives in Minnesota. Then from Onsare is we call him Seven. And that is the difference. Now, Seven is with his children, Andrew, the great footballer, strongman. Then Nyakara, she's the daughter again. Then after Robert, we have another brother called Peter. He was not able to arrive in time, but he's going to be here with us next week. Together with his family, they are also watching us online. Then we have another brother called Shem. He was not able to arrive. I'm sure he's also watching us online. Shem is followed by Susan. See, the numbers, I'm sorry, I've gotten lost. Because probably I was biased with men. And because we have too many men in that family. Peter is followed by then followed by Shem, also together with the family, they are also watching us online. Then from Shem, we have now Shadrach, number 11, together with Tracy and Jacob now. They are all here together, and they are the ones who have this wonderful, amazing man. We are going to say bye today. After Shadrach, there is one more called Nancy. Nancy, together with her family, they are also watching us online. There is one more we adopted, number 13. She's called Edith Osoro. And they, together with her family, they are also watching us online. In our families, my mom's family, The gentleman on my far right is our cousin, and this man was sacking. Thank you so much for making time to come. I want to introduce my brother, Ino. Please come so that you can also be in this group. Shem is my wife's brother, youngest brother. He lives in Dallas together with his family, and he had to come to join us and give us support during this morning time. Friends, it's hard to believe that Joseph has slept. When we got this news on the first of this month, it broke us as all our hearts were broken. We had no words to say. We had no wings to fly to America so that we would be able to be with the family and be able to comfort one another during that time. Joseph, some month in 2002, we were here to celebrate the wedding of Shadrach and Tracy. Soon after that, Joseph was born. Joseph was named after my father. My father was a clinical officer in the medical profession. And perhaps, even though he did not see my father and the way things were being done, he must have been inspired to become a doctor then. Same week. Joseph is therefore took the names of both my father and my brother who died that particular week. So his full names are Joseph Ogega, who is my brother, and Weso. We have been here a few times to enjoy and visit with our brother. Joseph has always exhibited in all that he behaves and does. The last time Joseph was in Kenya was when my mom, my late mom, was sick, and they came with their dad to be able to visit our sick mom. He had already grown, he was jovial, ever smiling, ever concerned, and ever responsible. We want to thank God for the many days that he gave us Joseph. And we want to thank God that Joseph, having gone through the system, and having, we believe, he died in the Lord, we will be able to meet him again. It's our hope that as a family, let us continue to be faithful and be strong so that we can be able to remember and cherish the memories that has been left behind. Our prayer is, may our Lord's grace be sufficient unto you. Jacob, visions are. Remember, Joseph is already asleep, and he knows that of what is going on today. But we who are alive, we know we are going to die. Let's prepare ourselves for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Then we will be able to be united with Joseph and the rest of our relatives. I know Grandpa and Grandma Sharon have lost a great friend. Not only a great friend, a companion, and a person that you could be able to sit together and love and make stories together. It's our prayer that may God's grace be sufficient unto you so that you can be able to come to terms with this kind of loss that we have all of us together. Our nephews and nieces who are watching us, we want to thank God for the life that He gave us Joseph. We will forever remember Him, and we will forever cherish the memories that He's given us. How we pray that, Lord, continue to give us of being united again one day. We want to thank you for the people who have made it possible for us to have this program. And as a family, we will not take it for granted. May the Lord bless you abundantly. Thank you.
Right. You invite one Kenyan, that means you invite all Kenyans. That's how we open. Yeah, so like I said, today is the first moment of remembering Joseph's memories, the joy and the light he brought into our lives. And also this moment to shed tears, because we know for sure that we are going to be able to see Joseph again. But like Henry said, and for those who read the Bible, we shouldn't be mourning like we're hopeless. We hope for one day to be united with Joseph. And so we commit to convert those stories and memories we've had about Joseph into things that we can implement in our hands. Personally, I'm not going to forget Joseph, because I'm still going to miss him. He made me look like a kid whenever I was in Egypt. But let's start. So at this moment,
I as well. I'm going to read from my thing because there's no way I'll get through it without. As I sat writing and rewriting what I was going to say and share today about Joseph and the life that we had with him here on earth, I couldn't get the image out of my mind of his amazing smile. And out of my head, the message.
sent to me in the form of a street sign on the last day that we were in Kenya. I'm not in Kenya, I'm sorry, the last day that we were in California. We had eaten at IHOP both mornings, and outside of IHOP on that last morning, I'm sitting there looking out the window, and I looked at my mom and I said, look at that. That was not there the first day. And it was this big, big street sign. And it simply read, relax, you are okay. That was just Joseph's way of always comforting me and calming me down when something was bothering me or when I was upset about something. He always was so positive and reassuring. Joe was never the kind of person to let things get him down. If something wasn't going right, or was just not going the way that he had intended for it to go, he would just simply go about it a different way, or tweak it a bit to make it work. Joseph never gave up on anything he set his mind to. Joseph's ultimate dream was to become an orthopedic trauma surgeon and to study cancer cell research. And Joseph would have made that dream a reality. Joe would have been a fourth-year pre-med student this fall, majoring in business management for healthcare. Joseph's passion and drive were full force. There were so many days that I remember calling him on my way home from work just to check in and see how the day had been and how everything had been going. And his answer almost always would be, hey mom, I'm good. I'm at the library or I'm at the coffee shop. That seemed to be the normal routine. If he wasn't in class or at work, that's usually where he was. I'm so incredibly proud of the man that Joseph was becoming. And in listening to all the words spoken about Joseph from friends, acquaintances, and loved ones in the days since Joseph's passing, it has made me even more proud of the person that he was. Joseph was a true friend to all that he came to meet and know. And to Joseph, a stranger he certainly did accomplish his dream of changing this world through the lives and the love. Through the lives that he touched and continues to touch. And the drive and the love that Joseph shared with every one of you. And spread it and share it with others in the way that he shared it with you so that we may continue to carry on his legacy.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm not good at typing, so I write it out. I always thought, what kind of kid did we raise? That was Joseph. I have two sons, Joseph and Jacob. You know, you can tell Jacob has not given a speech. Poor Yokos. One marriage approved. And Jacob was just fine. He's content. When Joseph you know, just smiling to every of you, everybody passes by. That was Joseph. Most importantly, Joseph was excited about the future. He knew he would succeed to be a doctor. He was not afraid to ask for advice. And they received advice. That was Joseph. To me, Joseph actually, sometimes, really, Joseph was a friend to me. When we talk in serious matters, Joseph would be like, "Hey, Dad, I have a plan." Pushed poor Jacob. You will hear, "Get out of my room! Get out of my room!" You hear that until I could not stand it. I had to go and say, "Go to your room." But he always, the teachers will let me know, he always said, but Dad, he always wants to have the last word. But he made you reach the point where you never been. Think about, you've gone to work, you worked for 10 hours, you're home, eat at the dinner table. Jacob knows that's why I hang out sitting, but I don't know why I don't sit on the comfort. "Hey, Dad, I haven't seen you go to gym. I can't see any login. You didn't scan it." So, he really, I started knowing. And then he said, "Yo, I see it." that's his friend Joe. "Yo, I see you. And then he sent me a picture from the gym at 11 at night. And I'll send him one. Tell his friend, "You, that's my dad. That's my friend Joe." We're not talking business there. Joe, you know, Jacob is a quiet boy. He likes to be content with the mom. Imagine you sitting at 11 o'clock during Christmas holidays in your living room. It's raining in Seattle, and somebody comes to you and says, "I think that's something we can do." That's yo. That's how we did. If you see so many pictures, it's Joseph is telling me it's Joseph figuring those things out. But there's one thing I'll tell you, my dear son. He was a troublemaker. His troublemaker is Joseph's car. Pastor Kabanji is all in that car. The light will come on, but he still knows he needs to South Central back. The gas light is on, but he knows it all. But I came to figure things out. I have a 10-gallon lawnmower gas in the garage, which I fill all the time. That thing will last me for 3 years. Every time I went, it was empty. Every week that thing was empty. He filled the gas in my garage. And then we start asking why. Because kindergarten is next room, all I hear all day, Joseph, go to your seat. Joseph, stop talking. Joseph, leave us at the salon. That was Joseph, the problem maker. But we raised an opportunistic son. He made us better. He thought about his family. Although he would say, you called, actually, it's a few months ago, you called. But Dad, you were too hard on me. How come you're not hard on Jacob? Always, but he's pushing us to make sure his brother does better, to make sure we do better as a family. Above all, I'm saying, Joseph loved everyone. Joseph respected him. Regardless of whom they work in the society. Students, college professors, customers where he worked, family, friends, family, and so on. Joseph's brother and a friend to Jacob, a cousin to many, nephews to many, and a friend to so many people, including the strangers he just meets. Our son, our great kid, gone too soon. We miss you already. But I promise your optimism, positive energy, strategic mindset, and above all your love for every stranger will be his legacy. We will carry on for you. I love you, son. Rest in peace. Until we meet again. Thanks, everyone.
It's no coincidence that Jacob was an individual that I was sitting by today, and the next few months are going to be hard. But you've heard it said that you have brothers and sisters here. I hope and pray that though we're mourning right now, we continue to look at our family, and continue to provide. It's no coincidence that Joseph was born on July 4th. It just hit me when I was reading his bio. July 4th, we celebrate Independence Day. We celebrate freedom. And that's who Joseph was. No coincidence that Jesus said, I'm going to make this young man born on this specific day. Because to us, he lived a free life. listening, had you only been there. And for Mary, the Bible says Jesus went. And my beautiful friends, wherever you may be today, I'm here to tell you that Jesus will meet you. Whether you need him to tell you that he's the resurrection, he's there. Or whether you need him to weep with you, he's also there. What I know about Joseph's relationship with Jesus was Joseph was built to show Jesus to the world. For all the friends who came up here to say Joseph was a catalyst of change, for those who came here to share your beautiful testimony, I want you to know that the reason why Joseph's life was so beautiful was because he was built to show Jesus. That was so special. He was built in every single way to show the beauty and the love of Jesus to us. There's a song that goes, "Oh death, where is your sting?" My beautiful friends, I know that today we feel the sting of death. First person to meet me when I came to Auburn was Joseph. And I know that when I get to heaven, the first person to meet me to say, "Hey, I got a plan, let's go have fun," it will be Joseph's son. I have this hope. I have this hope. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for the tears, the laughter. Thank you for showing all of us what Joseph meant to us, how he touched our lives. And now we have an opportunity to be like Joseph and show the world through our actions, through our words, through our smile. Who knew a smile could preach the gospel? Through our smile, that they are loved, that they are valued, that they belong, that they are cherished. We have that opportunity because that's what Joseph did. That's what he did for us. That's what he did for me. I need to apologize to both of you before I close. My wife and I were very jealous of Joseph. We looked at Joseph and said, "We hope our son friends, again, we have this hope that burns within our hearts, that when we get to heaven, Joseph will say, "Took you long enough." Let's pray. Father, we know that it wasn't enemy who did this. We also know, Lord, that even though we have the knowledge, our hearts are still in pain. Right now. But I pray for comfort. I pray that you may give us the right words for Shadrach. I pray, God, that you may give us the ability to mourn that also shows hope. I pray, God, that as the day gets closer, we may anticipate your return. And Jesus, in the meantime, Jesus, you are real. And we know you are real because we saw you every single day. So thank you, Father, for caring enough for us to give us Joseph. And thank you for today that you may gather a new family here. New brothers and sisters, fathers and mothers, uncles and aunties, grandmothers and grandfathers. We're all gathered here today because of your son. We're all gathered here today because of the beauty that we saw in his soul, because of the captivating smile, because of the desire to serve. And so today, Jesus, as we leave this holy ground, this holy space, may we leave in full confidence that we will see our brother, we will see our friend again. And again, Father, in the meantime, take away the sting of death. Breathe life into us again. We pray these things in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. And now it's with absolute humility that I'd like to just say two things. Thank you, and then to just ask for. If you're here today, or if you're watching this on a stream, a live stream, thank you for your support to this evening. Both your love, your physical support, and all kinds of other support that you've given to make this journey manageable, at least. And the second thank you to Joseph's family. Thank you so much for sharing Joseph with us on this earth. And to the wider universe, here he comes. And thank you for sharing Joseph with the entire universe. And now for the most high thank you to the Almighty Heaven. We're jealous of this angel by the throne tonight. And thank you for receiving this angel. And now for the three instructions. As we leave, I think we're moving from here to Mountain View, the cemetery. I hope you're holding on to one of these. There's instructions that gets the addresses on there on how to get there. Please follow these instructions as best you can. And then he'll be followed by his family members. And right behind me, behind you over there is Seth. Maybe you can raise your hand, Seth. You can see that gentleman. I ask you to please remain calm and patient, really, is what the word is, so that he will usher you out row by row. When he gets to your row, he'll let you know. And then the last and final thing here is that I'm told there's a service that's taking place immediately after this. This community is gracious enough to allow us the opportunity to use this space, and we're thankful. Please just carry whatever it is that you brought with you, because right immediately after this, we don't have a cleaning crew that will come back and clean. I appreciate this, and thank you so much.
I've been asked to repeat the instructions regarding hazards. So folks who are in the procession, please make sure your hazards are on as well as your lights. We will find you. Feels like we're not finding you, please pull forward. The verse is right here. We're going to be coming out of the main parking area. So please, if you're not in the procession, stay where you are to allow this family to join that procession. We are only taking 25 cars. So if you need to carpool, please do that and you'll return back to here at some point in time. I think that's about it. This part's going to be pretty quick for Joseph's family and for the funeral team. You're welcome to stay back, use the restroom, grab your belongings, and just make sure that you have everything so that when we get to the cemetery, everybody's home. There's a lot of us, the restrooms are going to be.